Mayor, thanks so much for joining us.
Oh, it's a pleasure to be here.
Good. Now, I want to talk about this film. It's fascinating. It points out that tens of thousands of African-American women contributed to the war effort. You were one of them. You went to Camden, I believe, in the 1940s. You worked at RCA. Tell me about your experiences there. What was the atmosphere at that time? Were you well-received as a black woman? And was racism rampant at your workplace and in Camden?
Well, during those years in Camden during the wartime, Camden was the place to be. It was a beautiful little town. In fact, we had jobs. And when you have jobs, people had homes that could educate their kids. We had the New York shipyard. We had RCA. We had Camel Soup. We had from paperclips to battleships. And at that time, I was hired at RCA, and that's where my life began. And it was a very interesting life. And if you want me to tell you just a little bit about RCA, you want to hear it?
Well, I just wanted to know how you contributed, and do you consider yourself a trailblazer? Do you think you and other black women like yourself, you know, change perceptions and stereotypes?
I would think so, because during the years that we worked at RCA, we didn't actually know the widget that we were making, but we knew it was pertaining to the war. But what was most fascinating, we had to work so hard. It was all about production. The thing I remember mostly, and it was so exciting, is we worked on a conveyor belt. There were from 60 to 80 people on this conveyor belt, and each one had a procedure to do. We had a schematic. And you worked and worked in the line, and the conveyor was running fast, and you didn't have time to even take care of your personal needs, and because you had to keep working. And I think we made this contribution because we had to make schedule, and we did all those good things. And even though it was during the years that we had some of the segregated things going on we didn't like, we still made a good contribution by keeping those supplies going for the wartime.
Now, do you think that your efforts were properly acknowledged? Do you think you're part of the greatest generation as well, you and other black women from that era?
Well, I think so, because even though we worked hard, we set our goals, but when they found out that I knew mathematics, and that was my major, that I knew how to keep time, well, they promoted me to a timekeeper. And from being in the office of timekeeping, I became active in all the other activities, even to the point that when I was 29, of course, I'm 87 now, but when I was 29, I actually modeled TVs for RCA. And I feel we made a great contribution. I was later on promoted to one of the supervisors. And many, many times I represented RCA as an African-American female.
Very nice. Well, I also want to point out you've been a longtime public servant and a resident in Camden. You've seen it over the decades. Now, how has it changed? Yes. You talked about there were plenty of jobs back then. Tell me about how it has changed.
Oh, the change has been obvious. Of course, as I mentioned earlier, that with jobs, people had homes, they had food, they could educate their kids. But then it began to change during the years when the flight of the people moved out of the neighborhoods and moved into the suburban areas. Then the towns became filled with abandoned homes and overgrown lots. And you didn't have the money, the businesses were gone, because I talked about all the industries. And I mean, we had about 15 different movies, and we had Horn and Harders, we had restaurants, we had hotels. But when all that left the city, it left it in despair. Mm. And you're talking about the change. When people do not have jobs, it's sad. And even now, as I compare it with the years that I talked about that we were prosperous, now it's so sad with people who don't have jobs, they can't pay their taxes. We can't even employ people to keep up the quality of life. And that's where the big change is.
So what is it going to take to bring Camden back?
I'd like to tell you what I did, and yet as a mayor, I had an experience that no other mayor had. In fact, I'm sure you know, along with the others, when they passed that MIRA Act, it was called the Revitalization Economic we accepted $175 million. Certainly, it was used for good causes, but I still feel I don't care who the developers are. I don't care how many come to the city. If the residents do not benefit, there's a problem. And as I look at it now, with people not being able to pay their taxes and do not have the jobs, it's to me, it's sad in the city of Camden to look at it what it was and how they have to suffer now with no money. Now, when I was the mayor, I like to talk about myself because it's not what I heard or someone told me, it's what I did. I followed a person as a mayor who went to prison. And can you imagine when they call me in and say, you don't have a secretary, you're the mayor. You don't have a president, you don't have a receptionist, you're the mayor. You don't have any money, you're the mayor. And believe me, I don't want to get in anyone's religion, but I said, oh, it's just me and you, Lord. And I had to say that, and it took a lot of prayer. And I would say to anyone in the Camden area that you have to come up with solutions. Even though they didn't trust me with the financial business, I had to find a new niche. And I can tell you exactly what that niche was if you want to hear it.
Well, so you're hopeful for Camden, though?
I am, because you have people are your resources. You must listen to your residents. Some of the things that I did, and it was beneficial and profitable, we organized outreach to empower the people, and they enjoyed it. We let them set their agendas, and under my leadership, we had the code enforcement to make sure that the landlords kept their properties clean.
And so you're saying this is what's needed. You have to empower the
people.
That's
what's needed, yes, okay. Absolutely.
All right,
yes.
Mayor, we're going to have to wrap it up there. It's fascinating to talk to you. Thank you so much for your time.
Oh, well, thank you so much.